This is the SAP Developer News for August 8th, 2024.
Hola,
SAP
developers.
We made it, as promised, to Latin America, the first of our 12 events over the next 2 weeks.
That's right. We have 2 core gems and 1 standfish per city. And we can't wait to start today with the event-driven integrations with SAP Integration Suite CodeGem.
And then a great Stammtisch this evening, followed by an SAP Build Apps CodeGem on Friday before we head out to Santiago, Chile, and our other stops on the roadshow.
Now, when it comes to these coding events, we want to make sure that we are all learning. That's you, our artists, learning about SAP technologies.
And that's us, the developer advocates. We are learning from you, the audience, our community, what the CodeGem means to you as an attendee. So be ready to answer these kind of questions from us at the CodeGem so that we can ensure these are the best events possible.
And of course, be ready to go.
Ciao. Ciao. From Sao Paulo.
Hey folks, Rich Alman here. Last week, Sebastian Wolf introduced ABAP open source namespaces. And traditionally, ABAP open source artifacts are published with names belonging in the customer namespace, so beginning with Y or Z. But of course, this leads to naming collisions and all other challenges. Now, with ABAP open source namespaces, developers can apply for their very own custom namespace to use for their open source ABAP projects. Sebastian has all of the details in his blog post with links to just about everything you would need to get started with your very own namespace. Taking a look at the list so far, and I see a few out there already, so make sure to grab your namespace today.
Hello, developers. We saw a major release for Cloud Application Programming Model in June. As of July 2024, the CAP release is now available. In serious language updates, the isActive entity in the context of Trapped-enabled entities can now be used in expression annotations. New updates on Node.js include a global configuration, cds.server.body_parser.limit, which allows restrictions on the accepted request body size for all endpoints of the server. In addition to this global configuration, there is a service-specific annotation, @cds.server.body_parser.limit, that can be used to specify different payload sizes for different services within the application. Java updates include the provision for avoiding transactions or select queries, and the @search.ranking annotation now enables specifying the relevance or weight for the entity elements. This enables weighted fuzzy search on HANA. Finally, in tools updates, we have 2 new commands to easily set up SAP Cloud Portal configuration via CDS add portal command, and to add configuration for SAP BTP Workzone Standard Edition via CDS add workzone standard command. Please visit Capaya documentation links in description for further details.
With the vision of the Intelligent Enterprise Suite, SAP aligns the release dates of new innovations, enhancements, and corrections for associated products to ensure they function as integrated solutions. The harmonized release calendar of SAP Cloud products, which are part of the SAP Intelligent Enterprise Suite, also includes SAP Analytics Cloud. For the upcoming Q3 release, the SAC product team has published a detailed blog post outlining all the new features and enhancements included in that release. For example, a prompt guide will now be available to provide guidance on the best usage of Just Ask AI features. Additionally, as a data analyzer user, you can now utilize the report interface, or RRI, in SAP BW Live Connections to jump from executed query to another report. To help you understand all the new features, the product experts have recorded as well a video demonstrating all the new major capabilities. Enjoy.